behalf of the 1387 law due to the solemnity of the Ascension of the Lord. Our celebrant this afternoon is Archbishop Gomez and other bishops of the diocese. All of our music will be found on the screens in front of you this afternoon. And as a reminder, once again, if you have cell phones, please turn them off, place them on silent. Thank you. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers, peace be with you. We gather this evening for the celebration of the Bishop Mass. Mass on the solemnity of the Ascension of our Lord Jesus Christ. So I'm very happy to be with all of you today for this special celebration. As you come to the end of the State Assembly, it's always offering the Mass especially for all of you, your families, and the Knights of Columbus. Knights of Columbus in the States have got a little problem with the mic. Yeah. That's life, isn't it? Let's start a celebration and knowledge of our seeds and prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess.
Amen. reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In the first book, Theophilus, I dealt with all that Jesus did and taught until the day he was taken up, after giving instructions through the Holy Spirit to the apostles whom he had chosen. He presented himself alive to them by many proofs after he had suffered, appearing to them during 40 days and speaking about the kingdom of God. While meeting with them, he enjoined them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise of the Father, about which you have heard me speak. For John baptized with water, but in a few days you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit. When they had gathered together, they asked him, Lord, are you at this time going to restore the kingdom of Israel? He answered them, it is not for you to know the times or seasons that the Father has established by his own authority, but you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, throughout Judea and Samaria, to the ends of the earth. When he had said this, as they were looking on, he was lifted up, and a cloud took him from their sight. While they were looking intently at the sky as he was going, suddenly two men, dressed in white garments, stood beside them. They said, Men of Galilee, why are you standing there looking at the sky? This Jesus who has been taken up from you into heaven will return in the same way as you have seen him going into heaven. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, may the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation, resulting in knowledge of Him. May the eyes of your hearts be enlightened, that you may know what is the hope that belongs to His call. What are the riches of glory in His inheritance among the holy ones? And what is the surpassing greatness of His power for us who believe? In accord with the exercise of His great might, which He worked in Christ, raising Him from the dead and seating Him at His right hand in the heavens, far above every principality, authority, power, and dominion, and every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the one to come. And He put all things beneath His feet, and gave Him as head over all things to the church, which is His body, the fullness of the one who fills all things in every way. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, I hope that you are having a wonderful and great convention. Has it been good?
Yes.
And I hope that it's been a time of renewal and fellowship among all of you. I think it's important to get together and share what's happening in your own life. lives, and especially the life of the church at this time, and renew our desire to be faithful and share the good news of the gospel with the people of all time. So we are united tonight with the first set of disciples, lifting our eyes up to heaven as we witness his ascension in the first reading of today's Mass. This is, as we know, a very special moment in the life of the church. The Lord is now seated at the right hand of the Father, and that is what he calls us to be. And Jesus rose from the dead on Easter Sunday. Now he goes up to heaven, in his humanity and in his divinity. Because he ascends to heaven, we have hope. Humanity has hope. That we will rise to that. We will rise, and one day heaven will be our home too. And as he rises to heaven, Jesus gives his church his mission on earth. As we hear in our gospel today, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. So, we all have the mission to go out and make disciples. We have this mission to go out and share the good news of Jesus and bring salvation to others. Salvation, as we know, comes from the Lord Jesus. Everything changes when Jesus comes into our lives. His light, his truth, and his beauty. He's the only way to happiness, and he wants everyone. So that's why each one of us, we are called to be missionary disciples. That's what Jesus means today when he tells his disciples, you will be my witnesses to the ends of the earth. So our Lord's words today call us to be missionaries. Not in a foreign country, missionaries, where we are. In that little part of the world that we live in our homes, in the places where we work, our schools, our neighborhoods, Jesus is calling us to sanctify our reality and our relationships so that everything reflects a little more the glory of God and his plans for the human family. So our mission is to make the love of God real. We concern every day to help our loved ones and the people we meet to go to heaven. And we all understand the urgency of that in our lives, in our society, in the world in which we live. So Jesus goes to heaven. He does not leave us alone on earth. He goes away, but he does not leave us behind. We have his promise today in the gospel. Behold, I am with you always until the end of the age. He is with us. Always. So, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to draw near to Jesus. We need to cling to him and follow him. Nothing will ever take God away from us. Nothing can ever separate us from his love. Today, let us ask for the grace to be witnesses to God's love. In the first reading today, we hear Jesus telling his disciples. Very interesting, because he tells them not to depart from Jerusalem, but to wait for the promise. And the promise, as we know, is the promise of the Holy Spirit on Pentecost. And I think this is also an obvious message to the church in every age. We all know what the first disciples, the first Christian, did after Jesus was lifted up into heaven. They did exactly what Jesus told them to do. They went back to Jerusalem with Mary, his mother, and they devoted themselves to praying together and waiting for the gift of the Holy Spirit that he promised to them. This is church has always been. This is how we need to live right now. Close to Jesus, close to Mary, united in the Holy Spirit, who is always there to help us. So yes, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to sit together. We need to pray together, united as one family, one body. It's important to us today in the second reading that the church is Christ's body on earth and that he is the head. If Christ is our head, that means we should always be striving to have the mind of Christ, to think like Christ, to act like Christ, to see the world as he sees the world, to love one another as he loves us. Sounds like a big challenge, doesn't it? But if this is our vocation, this is our call. And we need to obviously ask for the grace of God and renew, I would say, every day our desire to be another Christ, Christ himself. So the church, as we know, is a family. And right now, we need to do everything we can to take care of our brothers and sisters. We need to love like Jesus Christ, every one of us. So today, we are the witnesses to what St. Paul calls the surpassing greatness of his power for us who believe. Jesus came down from heaven to shape our human life in all our sufferings and joys. Today, he ascends into heaven so that we can follow him. Every road leads now to heaven. If we walk with Jesus, he goes with us. So let us keep walking with him as we all are trying to do. But don't forget that Jesus is alive. Christ is alive. And he is with us in every single moment of our lives. So today, let us ask the intercession of Blessed Michael McGivney, the founder of the Knights Columbus, who is in the words of Pope Francis, at seal and proclamation of the gospel and generous concern for his brothers and sisters. That's also a beautiful example that we are trying to follow. And let us turn also to our Blessed Mother Mary, the Queen of Heaven, asking her to help us to always have our eyes looking at heaven and our hearts open to our brothers and sisters on earth. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
brothers and sisters, as we now offer our prayers for our community and for the world, let us pray the Spirit of Blessed Michael Mandini, not only for ourselves and our own needs, but for the entire people.
Pray for the church and her work of evangelization. May God continue to lead her in integrity and truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who lead our local communities, our country, and our world, may God strengthen them with wisdom and fortitude. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray for all who suffer from despair. May God grant them abundant hope. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the faithful gathered here, may God inspire our lives to reflect His glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those who work to defend the lives of the unborn, the sick, the infirm, the aged, those who defend humanity's inalienable rights to life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our first responders, may they have courage to continue serving our community, looking beyond the risk for the sake of others who need our help and protection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all those ill and suffer in any way in body, mind, and spirit, and we remember those most acutely in need of the help of the Lord right now. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we pray for all who have passed away, especially those members and families of the Knights of Columbus. May God shine His eternal light upon them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Now in the silence of our hearts, we hold our own petitions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of mercy, you know the many needs of your people. Hear our prayers and grant us what we ask in faith. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
God, and the mighty Father.
The Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, our good and new all the Holy Church.
O God, whose only begotten Son, our High Priest, is seated ever living at your right hand to intercede for us, grant that we may approach with confidence the throne of grace and there obtain your mercy. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up to the Lord.
Give us attention to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is your right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere. We thank you, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For the Lord Jesus, the King of Glory, conqueror of sin and death, ascended today to the highest heavens, as the angels praise in wonder. Mediator between God and man, judge of the world and Lord of hosts, he ascended not to distance himself from our lowly state, but that we, his members, might be confident of following where he, our head and founder, has gone before. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Recognizing the sacrificial victim, I will send you into reconcile us to yourself. And that we are nourished by the body of brother, your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may we call one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance for your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for an ending help.
May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and our Archbishop Jose, the Bishop of this Diocese, Alberto, me, your worthy servant, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing in this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow the world all that is good.
Take away the
Holy Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to be supper of the Lord.
Father.
following the Savior's footsteps to the place where for our safety enter before us, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Archbishop Gomez, thank you so much for proclaiming and celebrating Mass with us today. Thank you. Thank you. the icon of St. Ruth Lucera, holding the mission of Carmel. And we are honored to present this to you. I have a little side note about this icon. This icon was designed by Deacon Lawrence Klemecki. And Deacon Lawrence just passed away, and his funeral was this past Thursday, unexpectedly. So this now has a special meaning in our hearts. But again, thank you. Tell them that you can get those prayers and the cue cards from us, the Knights of Columbus. These are special prayer cards that we have. You can get them from our website. Brother Jimmy Aitchison, our Evangelization and Faith Formation Director, joined us today. He's the creator of those prayer cards.
Oh, full-blown parade right now, which is nice.
Oh, yeah, we got it.